Worst motherfucker never loved her.
What's up, y'all? This is Anku with Buckeye Nation. I'm here to recap BN's last war against Orion's Nebula X. This war was our first playoff war in the MLCW, which is Minor League Clan War of the season. The final score was 57-53. And let's go ahead and take a look at the first attack here by Antonio. As you can see here, it's a 10v11. Antonio, in my opinion, is one of the best planners for 10v11 and does really well at noticing a base's weak points. As you can see here, he's dropping archers and bowlers around the base that are basically being untouched while they take out a decent amount of percentage. It's also helpful sometimes if you're able to do that and start a funnel. It's a very, very good to start off the attack this way, because the Eagle Artillery activates after a certain amount of time throughout the attack. As you can see here, his loons are taking out the 9 o'clock corner. That's to help with this funnel so you can get this town hall. Personally, I would not have even seen a funnel from that side. His queen ends up taking out the town hall, which surprised me when I watched it live. But, I mean, obviously, Ant was able to see something that I wasn't able to. And it paid off in the end, which was awesome. So, good job, Antonio. Let's go ahead and watch Silver Fox's attack on number two. Silver Fox is an awesome attacker. He does a great job of, again, using archers to take out some buildings and creating a good percentage. I thought it was super interesting the way that he overlaps his troops and the way that they drop. He drops them at 6 o'clock. As soon as the bowler was about to die, he drops the baby dragon. Then, as the baby dragon is about to die, he drops the wizard. And he's able to keep that funnel going without wasting too much troop space. And it's a very controlled way of dropping troops. I thought that was a pretty interesting way of doing it. We attacked this base this way multiple times, and we kept trying to get either the queen or the Eagle Artillery, or at least create a decent funnel for our troops that we were going to be sending in here in a minute, that you'll see we're coming from. And we just weren't able to really get as much percentage or as much as we wanted to down at 7 o'clock, but we're still able to get the 2-star, as you'll see here in a second. Personally, every time I've watched this, I thought the jump over that wall was unnecessary because the buildings were already funneled. I thought it would have been better to jump into the town hall compartment, because the king would have gone into there in case the queen circled. Because that is kind of what happened the first time. The king went around and the queen circled that we did this attack. But it ended up working out, which was awesome. Let's go ahead and watch Whiskey Jack. He's at 11. He's going to drop and hit number 3. He does a really good job at using hogs. Whiskey and Buckeye 80, I believe, are the top two leading Town Hall 11 v10 hit rate attackers in the MLCW right now. I think Buckeye 80 has 100%, and I think Whiskey is around 95-97% or something like that, which is really good. And we are very proud of those guys, and we're happy to have them on our team. And he just completely destroyed that base. I probably should have done it at 2 speed, but He just did a really good job, and it was a quick attack anyways. Here we have B80, our fearless leader, doing an 11v10. This attack is pretty interesting because his wall breakers end up attacking a compartment that he wasn't planning on them attacking, but he'd end up doing a really good job of recovering. His goal was to take out the two air defenses and the Inferno and possibly the Queen, but his kill squad ends up walking. Interesting thing about wall breakers, which I feel like a lot of people don't understand, is that they really actually kind of target buildings, but they blow up walls. So they'll go towards the closest building inside of an enclosed compartment, and if right before you drop them, the building that was the closest gets destroyed, then they will target the next compartment over, and your entire attack could get fucked over. So it's just something to know about, and a fun fact that a lot of people don't really pay attention to as far as it comes to wall breakers. Anyways, great attack, B80. He did a really good job. Alright, so the next attack is going to be by me. It was deleted during the maintenance break. The replay wasn't available after the war, but luckily I had recorded it beforehand. Simply because I was proud of the attack, I was able to swag some spells and some troops, and also could have swagged my queen ability, but just, you know, when you're at the end of the attack and you want to get it over with, yeah. Sometimes we'll do things to speed things up. Anyways, I noticed that I could queen walk a decent amount of this corner because there wasn't really any point defenses, so I started my queen walk over here. When you raid your wall breakers, even if there is a mini-bomb, like as you saw, they'll usually be able to blow up before the mini-bomb goes off because they're raged and their speed is heightened. And I could just drop a golem with some bowlers in the CC over at 12 o'clock and let them walk around because there wasn't really much to worry about up there. Basically, I kind of just broke the base down in my head before I attacked it. And kind of just let my troops go for a little bit here, and then after a little bit here, you'll see I'm going to start dropping my flight. I'll let the attack continue, and I'll hit record again after a second. Alright, here's going to be a giant bomb, and so I'm going to heal my bowlers. If that giant bomb hadn't exploded, I might have been able to swag that heal as well, although, I mean, there's a kind of two Teslas, a cannon, and an archer tower, so the heal was the best use there anyways. I only brought one hound because I figured there'd only be one air defense by the end of the attack. There ended up being two before my flight was able to get up to there, but luckily it doesn't matter because there's just so many loons, and that base is toast. So yeah. This attack is by MK. He does a really good shattered go over here. I was scared when I saw the spells in his comp here. He brought a lot of wizards for a very wide funnel. This is Stone Go. Brought a lot of wizards with a very wide funnel and only one heal for his hogs. And his hogs do end up dying out, but he ends up having enough time to recover, and his heroes do a good job of cleaning up at the end. But, yeah, I don't know, it was a really hard base to crack. Obviously, he needed two jumps if he wanted to get into the core. But at the same time, a raid with his on his bowlers did a really well job, which really only left him with one spell, but he made do with it and got the three, so good job, MK. Here's another attack by MK. A lot of our replays are gone because the maintenance happened right in the middle of war, the maintenance break, and so we lost a lot of replays. But here he didn't even bring a golem. He just brought some wizards to funnel his heroes so he could take out these two air defenses which were exposed, which is a really good plan. And then the CC gets lured, which was a golem, which was perfect because he doesn't have to worry about the CC. He can completely forget about a poison and bring a skeleton spell instead, max skeleton spell for that queen. As you see here, he rages over the expo compartment and the queen. Here in a second, I'll show you. There it is. And the queen, and then that's when he drops his Skelly's spell to take out that queen, and it just does a really good job. And to be honest, he could have swagged these two haste here, but he go ahead and drops them anyways, and he gets the three. Good job again, MK. Nice six pack. Next up, we got Ed, I think another six pack this war. Did a really good queen walk here with Shattered Goho, I guess you could call it. He does a very, very interesting plan. It's pretty intricate. He comes down here at the bottom and just lets his queen pretty much take out the CC and the enemy queen. He notices that, you know, the point defenses are pretty spread out, so she won't be taking a lot of DPS all at once. Then he goes ahead and he drops his kill squad up there, take out the Teslas, and create a wide funnel so his kill squad will end up meeting up with his queen, so she ends up not taking up too much DPS. And just does a really good job of, you know, funneling pretty much everything right into the core. And his heal spell placements are really, really well placed. One over the bomb tower, an expo, and then the next one over the expo, wizard tower, and giant bomb. And that's a swag poison right there. Well done, Ed. Alright, let's go to the next attack by Ed. And yes, he did six back this war. So here he goes, Max Golem. I've seen a lot of more Max Golems being used in the CC, not only for offense, but also for defense since the update. They're pretty good tankers. I mean, normally when you would drop a Golem at this point, that Golem would be, you know, completely useless against a queen. You'd be basically feeding it against the queen, and your kill squad would not have been able to get that entire compartment, but he gets it. And gets a really good portion of the base, so there's not much that left for his flight to take care of. One thing I wanted to point out here too is he drops his rage over the expos, which is important since loons were nerfed. It does more damage over the expos because they have more HP, and ends up taking those out really nicely, and gets the 3-star. Good job, Ed. And that was the war. Motherfucker. Remember? Worst behavior.